Now in this class we are going to discuss addition theorem and multiplication theorem. Now in the previous class we already discussed probability, basic concept of probability, what are the definitions required to define probability, we discussed already in the previous class. Apart from that, before going to take problems based on the basic concepts, I want to discuss few more theorems. One is addition theorem already on the board, another one is multiplication theorem. Why you need to study for addition and multiplication theorem? This theorem is very much useful whenever you want to find out probability of involving more than one event. Now for example, I want to find out the probability of A union B. Means keep in mind, if you they have in the statement they have two events, say A and B have two events you have. Now if you want to find out at least one must be happen, if you want to find out at least one must be happen means there we are going to use in between the A and B using the connectivity is nothing but union. Keep in mind, suppose they are having a three events say A, B, C. If you want to find the probability of at least one must be happen means in between A, B, C I have to give a connectivity for union. At least means I told in my first class union. Suppose they are having three events, all R must be happen means in the I want to find the probability of all R must be happen means I have to take in between the events A, B, C must be a intersection. Now this is a difference between to find out the probability of at least and both. All means in between that I to take a connectivity. Now for example, I want to find out probability of at least one must be happen. Probability of A union B union C, at least one must be happen. From the definition of probability, now I am going to write probable favorable number of cases of A union B union C. It's not easy to connect the favorable number of cases of A union B union C because the meaning of A union B union C means either belongs to A or belongs to B, belongs to C, belongs both A and B, belongs to B and C or belongs to A and C or maybe belongs to A, B, C also. I have to collect all such type of elements and then I have to write these are the favorable number of cases. That's not easy, it's very tedious. If you want to overcome, there we are going to use addition theorem. Okay. If you want, now similarly, I want to find the probability of all R must be happen means now collection of common cases between A, B, C, not only A, B, C, they are having 4 events, 5 events, 10 events, it's not easy to collect common case from the Venn diagram. It's not easy to write Venn diagrams whenever having more number of events. Therefore, if you want to overcome, they are using multiplication theorem. Okay. Now I am going to explain what is addition theorem. The addition theorem is, for example, I told already few minutes, just 1 minute before, addition theorem we are going to use to simplify whenever I want to find out probability of at least one must be happen. Means whenever I use the connectivity between the events what actually union. In that case, we are going to use what actually this one union. Now, writing a formula for addition theorem depends upon what type of events. Keep in mind, first you observe what are the events you have, what type of events, whether the events are mutually exclusive or not. This is my sample space from the Venn diagram. Suppose events are look like A and B, there is no common between A and B, means both A and B are disjoint. Disjoint means what's the word we are going to use in the probability? Mutually exclusive. Means A intersection B is empty. A intersection B is empty. I want to find out probability. Keep in mind probability of what is none set. So what's the minimum value of the probability? Zero. We already discussed in the last class. Maximum probability is one. Therefore, whenever the events are mutually exclusive, probability of A and B can be written as some, just some of their probabilities. This is a formula. The case is the given events, given event is nothing but what type of event is mutually exclusive. Okay. The next cases, suppose event is look like it's not mutually exclusive. It's not mutually exclusive means they must be having common. They must be having common. Say like that, A and B. They must be having common. In such cases, no, probability of A intersection B is not empty. Therefore, probability of A intersection B is not equal to 0. It's not equal to 0. In such cases, what's the formula for probability of A and B? Probability of A plus probability of B, what you written the first one. One extra thing is, observe probability of A means, observe carefully, probability of A means this common area comes in for A. Probability of B, again this area comes twice. I want to remove once. Therefore, I have to subtract one part, minus probability of A intersection B. This is a formula. The events are not mutually exclusive. Okay. Keep in mind, if you want to go for addition theorem, most of the students they are going to confuse. If you want to go for this addition theorem, first point is whether in the probability between the events having a union. And next, and then observe whether the events are mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive means I go for first formula. They are not mutually exclusive means I go for the second formula. This is the way I to write the addition theorem. I explain how we have to subtract one part because this part is repeated twice. Okay. Proof already written in my e-content notes. So please go through that. It's very simple. And not only for two events, suppose they are having a three events, say A, B, C, probability of A union B union C. In that case, again observe A, B, C are mutually exclusive, then all events are mutually exclusive. In that case, what's the formula I took to sum of their probability? I have to write probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C. Suppose they are not mutually exclusive. That is a one thing that to write for the extension of the probability of A union B union C. This is a very very important while solving a problem. Okay. Now see, in that case, I think you know that they are not mutually exclusive. How this look like in the Venn diagram is nothing but this is a thing they having based on that, I have to write probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C minus. Now, not only for two events, now I go for three events also. Now, yeah, that is for exercise. You try and do it. That and also they are given in the textbook. Not necessary to discuss all the things on the board. That is a very very important concept. How to proceed for union and intersection. Okay, that is to observe carefully and then I to do it very carefully. What happened? Probability of A union B union C. Suppose A, B, C are not mutually exclusive. And also I am going to share my notes. What is the probability of A union B union C? Probability of A plus probability of B. See, observe carefully. Probability of A, probability of B, probability of C. Which portion is repeated? Please write probability of A this, probability of B is this. Is repeated which portion? This portion twice. And also probability of C. Probability of C. Which portion is repeated twice? This. Observe carefully. These things I have to subtract. Probability of A. Yeah. Probability of B. Okay. Yes. Which portion? This portion. These are the portions are repeated. What I am putting is shaded area. Yes. These things I have to subtract. Okay. Once you subtract, now I have to add common area. Probability of A plus probability of B plus probability of C plus probability of A intersection B intersection C minus probability of A intersection B probability of B intersection C minus probability of A intersection C. Because this portion we are deleting here, here, entire thing are deleting, therefore we have to add once, therefore extra one thing ahead we get probability of A intersection B intersection A plus probability of B plus probability of C plus probability of intersection B intersection C minus A intersection B probability of B intersection C and also probability of A intersection C. That's a formula for probability of A, B and C. You observe carefully, I explain this part is limited in all the cases. I have to add that if I have to write A intersection B intersection C. Yeah, I'm showing that my E continues is there in the proof and also is there in the textbook. You go through very carefully and take care for that part. I think it's clear. What I told, that is a thing, if you want to write it, this probability of A plus probability of B plus, I'm not going to put on the board, plus probability of C minus probability of B intersection B minus probability of B intersection C minus probability of A intersection C and also I have to subtract probability of A intersection B intersection C. This part. Which part? This part. This part also I have to subtract. Okay. This is a formula for probability of A union B union C. Suppose they are not mutually exclusive. They are mutually exclusive. Therefore, probability of A union B union C is nothing but probability of A plus probability of B and probability of C. Yeah, this proof I'm going to share with the E content. Please refer it. Okay, now we move to the multiplication theorem. Now, in a multiplication theorem, keep in mind, before we are going to take multiplication theorem, I want to explain one thing, that is nothing but conditional probability. Yeah, I want to explain conditional probability. The conditional probability is one of the important thing. So keep in mind, this multiplication theorem is very much useful whenever all are happen. Suppose having the two events A and B, all are happening for probability of A intersection B. If you want to find out probability of all R must be happen, both R must be happen, or suppose having more than two, A intersection B intersection C, in that case we are going to use this theorem, multiplication theorem. Now, before I am going to explain multiplication theorem, I am going to explain conditional probability. Yeah, I am going to give one simple example to understanding conditional probability. Because most of the students, they are going to confuse what is the conditional probability. Especially this is very much important in a Bayes theorem also. Okay, fine. In the conditional probability, yeah, condition, I am going to give one live example, it's not in the textbook. The example is, there are two students are there. Yeah, just imagine there are two students. I am taking class, my name is Dr. K. Rupa, my initial is KMR. Okay, KMR is entering probability class offline, not for online. Or if you want to take online also. Yeah, my class start from 9 to 10. My schedule is 9 to 10. A is what he is going to do here. Even though he is get ready to log in for online class for 8:55, he is not going to log in. Even though he is logging, he is going to immediately log out. Why? Because he is waiting for B. Once the student B is logging, immediately A is going to log in my class. Therefore, attending A is depending upon attending of the student B. Therefore, means A B happened, then only is happening. Such type of probability is called conditional probability. While writing the probability of A, I'm going to write probability of A slash B. Means A B happened, then only A happening. Such type of probabilities are nothing but conditional probability. What's the condition for attending my class? What's the probability of attending the student A in KMR class? Is nothing but probability of A slash B, because happening is depending upon B. If B happened, then only A happening. Such type of events probability is nothing but conditional probability. Suppose we are having three students. I'll give another example. Now I'm going to give one problem to these three students. The first A, yes, A, the event A is solved first. And then A is solved first, B is solved second, C is solved third. E for first, after that B is solved, after that C is solved. Now I want to write the probability of A. A is solved first, I feel A is solved independently. What's the word I use? In solved independently. Keep in mind, while writing a probability for this, all are solved. All are solved means what? Probability of A is solved, B is solved and C is solved. Means probability of A intersection, B intersection, C. All are solved. But while writing the probability of A is nothing but P of A, because E solved first, what I feel is solved independently. Even though B is solved after A solved, therefore what I feel is taken help from B, A, you taken help from A, E solved. Therefore, while writing probability of B is B slash A. Means, after A solved, B solved, therefore you taken help from A, therefore E solved. Then third, the last C solved. Is last C solved, he may be taken from B, but indirectly is taken help from A. Why? Because B is already taken help from A. Therefore, while writing the probability of C is nothing but probability of C is depends upon both A and B. Please try to understand C is indirectly depending upon A because B is already dependent on A. Therefore, while writing the probability of C is nothing but C slash of A and B, both A and B is taken indirectly help from A because B is already taken help from A. Okay, this is a way I have to write the probability. Then these two are nothing but example of conditional probability. Maybe involving more than one events, how to apply the condition probability. Whenever they have a condition, B happened, then only A is happening. B happened, then only A is happening means A slash B. Here, the A happened, then only B happening. A and B are happened, then only C is happening. This is a meaning. What are the after the slash you have that are independent? These are the before the slash that event is dependent. Yeah, keep in mind what's the word I used, independent. Keep in mind if you want to go for multiplication. Now I think clear everyone additional conditional probability. Next I'm going to write multiplication theorem. Again under multiplication theorem have two formulas. Depends upon the events are what type, whether the events are independent or not. Yeah. The keep in mind, if you want to go for multiplication theorem, events are connected between what actually intersection. Means all are happened. I want to find out probability of both must be happened. In that case, if we want to simplify further, now I am going to use multiplication theorem. If you want to go for multiplication theorem, in that case, we have to use independent and dependent events. Now, suppose events are independent, means either A attended or see, now I start my online class 9 to 10, okay? Either B is coming or not, A is attending my class. Attending the probability of A in my class is not depending upon B. Both are B also, either A coming or not is attending. Both are attended independently. In that case, the probability of A intersection B is nothing but probability of A into probability of B. Product of their probabilities, the condition means events are independent. Events are independent. Okay. Now, suppose events are not independent. I told in the last class, is not independent, means they may be having, even though they salt, what about that, they are not independent, means I can know which event, just few minutes before I explain condition probability, which event depends upon another one, either A or B. Suppose B depends on A, now probability of A intersection B is nothing but A probability of A into probability of B dash A. Suppose A is dependent on B, means probability of B into probability of A slash B. This is the way I to write the product of the probabilities using multiplication theorem, depends upon events are independent or not. Here events are not, events are dependent. They are not independent, they are dependent. They are dependent. This way I have to the probability of at right, I have to simplify by using multiplication theorem. Some of the product of the probabilities, maybe I have to use here also product of probability, but observe whether the events are dependent or not. Yeah, keep in mind, before move to the next step, again I have to recall addition theorem means I to observe whether whether events are connected using union, and then events are mutually exclusive or not. Mutually exclusive means we are going to write some of their probabilities, other means we are going to subtract the common cases in A from the both the events. And multiplication theorem will mainly depends upon condition probability. In the condition probability, how well comes condition probability, any event is depending upon other, it's not dependent, they are not independent, events are not dependent, independent, they are dependent. In such cases, we are going to take condition probability. Depend upon what? That comes after the stash. Okay. If you want to write multiplication theorem, theorem expansion, observe whether the events are giving a connectivity using intersection, and also whether the events are independent or not. Suppose events are independent, just try to write product of their probabilities. Suppose they are not independent, means they are dependent, means which event is depend upon which one. That observe carefully, based on that try to write the condition probability using condition probability concept and to write the product of A. Similarly, what's the probability of A intersection B intersection C? Suppose they are independent, you know some of the product of their probability P of A into P of C. Suppose they are not independent, means they are dependent. Dependent means which one is independent, which one is happened first. Suppose A happening, then only B and C are happened, means probability of B I am going to write slash A, probability of C I am going to write A intersection B means B happening. Well, suppose A happened, then C happening, suppose both A and B are happened. Suppose three students are there, A and B, C. Suppose A attending my class, B is attending my class, A must be attending my class. A already logged in, then only B is logging. Means probability of B slash A, what you told. C is must be logging, means you observe whether both A and B are logging. Therefore, why writing probability of C slash of A intersection B? Therefore, this is way I to apply multiplication theorem. Keep in mind, addition theorem is observe two things, union, connectivity is union and mutually exclusive events are not. In the multiplication theorem, whether the events are connected between the events are intersection and events are dependent or independent. Based on that, we have to apply multiplication theorem and addition theorem. Why we are apply the multiplication theorem is clear. Instead of finding this, just you find out the P of A, P of B, P of C, then you take product, that gives rise probability of intersections, intersection C. Then easy to find out the probability for this part compared to this part. Like that, same thing for in the addition theorem also. Now I am showing entire thing in one screenshot, what is addition theorem and multiplication theorem. And I think everyone is clear, observe carefully addition and multiplication theorem. Fully exclusively in this class I explained addition and multiplication theorem. In further two classes I am going to take problems based on these concepts, how to find out the solution of the given statement to given statement they given in the theoretical form. First you have to convert into mathematical notation, means P of A, P of B, P of C, and then use either addition theorem or multiplication theorem. Sometimes you are using both addition and multiplication theorem based on the given statement to solve the problem. With the help of that, to solve and find out the solution, we are saying that that's the solution of the given statement. What we give in the solution for that statement 100% is not correct. Keep in mind, whenever I have to solve the problem numerically, based on the numerically or based on theoretical statement, with the help of statistics and probability, it's not given as almost 100% accuracy. We are trying to find out our best approximation, 98-99%. That's why we are using different type of methods to find out the solution in the probability also, in the statistics also. Whenever they are giving a very much error in any column method, we are moving to the next method. We try to find out best approximation solution. The question is arise, even though they are not given 100% accuracy, why we are going to use probability? See, probability has to give a solution whenever in the statement having a uncertainty or ambiguity. You can't do it directly, it's not given in a direct form. That point is easy to highlight to clear where in the base theorem. Once you observe the problem, you must be you have a confusion, you have an ambiguity. You can't take addition in the form of uncertainty. In such cases, instead of you can't write a solution, at least I have to write some approximation solution is okay. Therefore, we are going to adopt statistics and probability, especially for probability, whenever having ambiguity and uncertainty, there we have to, if you want to find out at least approximate, best approximate solution, there we are going to use probability. Therefore, probability is a very, very core and important, especially in AI and ML, artificial intelligence and machine learning. These concepts is statistics and probability pakka, then easy to understand that concept. Then thank you very much for listening. Please come back for the revise before we go through the next video. Please recall this and then go to the next video, then easy to understand. Bye, see you and take care.